Hello everyone. In this video, we'll be using the definition of logarithms to evaluate some logarithmic expressions, and we'll be using the same to solve certain logarithmic equations. We know from the definition of logarithm that if the logarithm of x to base b is m, then that b, the base raised to power m, must give us x. So let's get started. We're going to be evaluating these expressions first using the definition of logarithms. The first one, we are to evaluate the logarithm of 10 to base 10. Then we can let the logarithm of 10 to base 10 be say k. From the definition of logarithms given earlier, we know that the base 10 raised to power k must be 10, and 10 there on the right hand side means 10 raised to power 1. When we equate the exponents, k is simply equal to 1, meaning that log 10 to base 10 is 1. The second one is the log of 0.04 to base 5. And we're first going to write that 0.04 as a fraction. And that gives us log 4 over 100 to base 5, which is going to be log 1 over 25 to base 5. Then at this point, we can let the log of 1 over 25 to base 5 be m, and from the definition of logarithm stated earlier, we know that 5 raised to power m must be equal to 1 over 25. This can be written as 5 raised to power m equals to 1 over 5 raised to power 2. And one of the laws of exponents is the fact that 1 over 5 raised to power 2 is 5 raised to power minus 2. Again, we equate the exponents. And when we do so, m is definitely negative 2. And therefore, we can say that the log of 0.04 to base 5 is negative 2. The third expression to evaluate is the logarithm of 32 to base 2. As usual, we can make a representation for that, saying let the log of 32 to base 2 be say y. And from the definition of logarithms, we know that 2 raised to the power of y must be equal to 32, and 32 can be written as a power, and that is 2 raised to power 5. Then we equate the exponents. Meaning that y is 5. Therefore, the log of 32 to base 2 is 5. The fourth one is the logarithm of 1/64 to base 4. So as usual, we let that be represented by a variable. So let's log 1/64 to base 4 be n. Again, and as usual, 4 raised to power n is going to be 1/64. And that means 4 raised to power n will be 1/4 raised to power 3, as 64 is 4 raised to power 3. And that can be written as 4 raised to power n equals to 4 raised to power -3. Then we equate the exponents. Now, equating the exponents means that n is -3. And that simply means that the logarithm of 1/64 to base 4 is the same thing as -3. The definition of logarithm can also be applied to solving some simple equations in logarithms. We'll take these examples to show that. The first equation we want to solve involving logarithm is the logarithm of 8 to base x equals to 3. So from the definition earlier on, we know that x, the base raised to power 3, must be equal to 8, and 8 can be written as a power of 2, so that x raised to power 3 will be equal to 2 raised to power 3. And since the exponents are equal, 3 in both cases, it means that the bases must also be equal. And therefore, x must be 2. The second equation in this category is the logarithm of 7 minus 2x to base 3 equals to 1. Again, 3 raised to power 1 must be equal to 7 minus 2x, and 3 raised to power 1 is 3, which must be equal to 7 minus 2x. And here we subtract 7 from both sides. Meaning that on the left hand side we have 3 minus 7, and on the right hand side it is going to be 7 minus 2x minus 7. And on the left hand side, on the right hand side, 7 is going to cancel out -7, and 3 minus 7 on the left hand side is -4, and that will be equal to -2x. Then we divide both sides by -2 to get the value of x. And that simply means that we have -4/-2 to be equal to -2x/-2. So that 2 is the same thing as x, that is x is equal to 2. The last equation will be taken in this video on simple logarithmic equation is the log of x squared minus 4x plus 5 to base 5 equals to 0. So again, 5 raised to power 0 must be equal to x squared minus 4x plus 5. And 5 raised to power 0 from the law of exponents and power is 1. And that must be equal to x squared minus 4x plus 5. This we can write as x squared minus 4x plus 5 equals to 1. That's flipping. We now have a quadratic equation on our ends. So we subtract 1 from both sides. Meaning that we now have x squared minus 4x plus 5 minus 1 equals to 1 minus 1. So on the left hand side, we have x squared minus 4x plus 4. While on the right hand side, we are left with 0. And what is now left is to solve the resulting quadratic equation. Using the method of factorization to solve this, we'll be looking for the factors of plus 4. And when added together, they give us negative 4. And these are negative 2 and negative 2. Therefore, our quadratic equation becomes x squared minus 2x minus 2x, as those are the factors, and plus 4 equals to 0. Going for double grouping, we group these two together and we group these two together. So from the first grouping, the highest common factor is x. We take it out in a bracket and we'll be left with x minus 2. From the second bracket, we could take out negative 2 so that we also end up with x minus 2 in the bracket, all this equal to 0. Then the two terms that we have reduced this expression to now has x minus 2 in common in brackets. So we take that out. When we do so, we also have x minus 2 in the resulting second bracket, and that equals to 0. And when two products are equal to 0, that is product AB, if it is 0, it can only mean two things. A is either 0 or B is either 0. Even a third thing, both of them could also be 0. Then in that case, x minus 2 is 0 as the first bracket, or the second bracket, x minus 2 is 0. So going by the first one, if x minus 2 is 0, x must be 2. second one, if x minus 2 is 0, x must also be 2. Here we can say that x is 2 twice, and that solves the logarithmic equations for us. If you are yet to subscribe to this channel, please do so. Click on the notification button so that you can get more of our videos. Thanks for watching. Bye.